In seeking an answer to these problems, Alfred Wolfson arrived at his thesis, which is that the voice is not the function of any anatomical structure, whether it be called the larynx or the diaphragm or what have you, but rather the expression of that mysterious something called the personality. These were the problems which occupied the mind of Alfred Wolfson and led him to his work with the voice. Working at first with sick voices and later with young and healthy ones, he broke the sound barrier of custom. He proved that the voice is restricted only by the limitations of the personality and inhibited only by the problems of the psyche. He discovered anew the latent potential in the adult voice, the voice which he could always hear with his inner ear, a voice without chains, the voice of the human being with love. The two normal functions of the voice are speaking and singing. Both are used for communication and both for expression. In the speaking voice, the usual range in everyday communication is about 5 semitones, thus. In expression of anger or fright, or when used for dramatic purposes, as for instance on the stage, it is extended to about 1.5 octaves, thus. However, my voice, as you have heard it in this introduction, covers over 5 octaves, thus. You may find this difficult to believe, but this can be checked, as any scientific experiment can be checked, and repeated at will. In the singing voice, the normal range is 1.5 to 2 octaves, as for instance in this male voice, singing 2 octaves from the bass F. This is repeated by a female voice descending from the top soprano C. You have now heard the normal range for male and female voices in singing. This range, too, can be extended, as you will hear from the examples that are to follow.